here at the restaurant.
Well, I get rained on. Camp was officially all set, and I'm pretty happy with the location. We're gonna head up to Misty Moon and got both the fly rod and the spinning rod. Throw a dry fly around, throw a spinner around, and see what we can get. We all went to a jig and a plastic, and got a nice lake here. I mean, it's not a giant, but look at that. Man, above the tree line, it feels like I should have like a doll sheep tag or something up in Alaska. This is an awesome valley in here. It's fucking beautiful out here. That's all I can say. Look at that freaking cutthroat on the dry fly, and there's a ton of them this size in this lake. Alright, we'll get the hook out of him. been a few rumbles of lightning, I mean, or thunder, ways off. Really not ideal. I might try to sit underneath some rocks to stay dry and hopefully don't get hit by lightning, but it's another, honestly, 2 miles before I can get some cover, so fishing's good. See if I can't hide somewhere here at 10,800 feet and try not to die in a thunderstorm. But first, let's try to catch some more fish, I guess. Well, rain's died down. We got a pretty little cutthroat. Just the colors on him, bronze. Nice cut, and let him go. Guys, I wish it wasn't on and off rain because I get the big camera out. It's not waterproof, but the action we're having right now, dry fly bite, slow down, and see if I can't sit you up somewhere. That'll do. Now we're on a jig and a plastic bite. Just a nice cutthroat. Get him back in. And a lot of these fish you can see hit, which is a ton of fun. Looks like we're about done with rain though. At about 4 or 5, we'll head down. We got 2.5 miles down in the canyon. Yeah, let's keep fishing. This is so much fun. I love cutthroat. Especially this is the highest elevation I fished, 10,800 feet. That is up there. So, right there is a ticket. It works. Fun catching them on the ultralight. All right, we'll let this beautiful big male go. Spawning colors. I mean, just freaking incredible. Look at his cheek, man. On the caddis. Freaking nice out now. Although it looks like it might try to build some more storms out there, but we'll fish here for another hour or two because this is fun.
Tilt your chair back, look up at the trees, let your hair down, listen to the breeze, breathe this moment down into your knees, let your worries for tomorrow fall amongst the leaves, with your best loved mug full of quitting time tea, sip the present, gift wrapped from eternity. Lay your treasure deep into your mind to dust off on a gray day when you need a ray of shine. When your weary shoulders start to slouch in from holding all that weight that you can't see. When there ain't a steady foot to stand on, you're too quick to thinking on your feet. When your smile fades, when your heart lags, toss your care down.
I might have found the greatest camp spot ever. I think that lens is dirty. for the hill better. This valley or canyon, I guess it was a canyon now, starting in the valley, is just so fucking beautiful. I mean, this is a view from camp. Yes, that's real. And then we got this big set of waterfalls over here. We got, I don't know, like a 40-yard scramble to water. And then backside of this. And I think we're within probably a mile and a half of where I'm day hiking to tomorrow, so. This is just insane. And then back up top, perfect little spot, put a tent. This is tomorrow, wake up, and it is Independence Day. And not a better place to spend than here for America's birthday. You know, really do feel free out here. Alright, well, we'll try to get things dried out. Let it spit a little bit longer, but it looks like the sun's coming out. So, maybe we can get a clothesline hanging up. Yeah, okay. Totally worth the hike, even though it's going to kill me going back up tomorrow. When your smile fades, when your heart lags, toss your care down. Well, I chose a shitty scramble coming up this. Could have gone up along the side of the waterfall at the first lake, but it's alright, because this is our view. I don't feel like I'm on Earth anymore. It's supposed to be awesome. Look at it. This is the second lake. These first two have fish in them. Already see one that surfaced over there. So we're gonna drop down to right here where there's probably a little outlet to the second lake, or to the first lake, and fish that, but holy crap. There's a pretty big cutthroat right by this rock. I'm gonna see if I can't get him up into the upper lake. See his eggs right here? Probably trying to spawn. Nice one too. Easy, easy. There he goes. Helped him out. Maybe. Maybe he wanted to be stuck. I don't think that counts as catching one, but they're spawning, so I'm gonna try. Caught one already. But I'm gonna try. See if they're pushing up to this outlet of this upper lake here. Just an absolute gorgeous cutthroat. She goes on the spinner. It's a good place to be catching fish. My goodness. That explains why that fish was super skinny. It's just going for the net. Just a spawned out female. Skinny dark fish. Well guys, since I showed you those two fish, I've been hammering them on the spinner. They're kind of on the shallow ledge here, cruising around, and see how many more I can get. Panther Martin, I think is what it is. Orange, gold blade. They're high mountain fish. They're not very great. Not quite the size we've seen yesterday, but there's the names. Kind of near the outlet here too. So that feels like a good fish right there. Looks like a good fish too. Woo! Hard to beat big cutthroat. I'm out like I did.
That is what we came up here for, man. Is that a giant compared to, you know, just cutthroats in general? No, but that certainly is a good fish in a place like this. 10,600 feet, and I think we're just gonna keep hammering fish all day.
Well, looks like some storms are trying to build, even though it's to the east, there's some thunder rumbling, but I wanna get one last fish before I ran out of here and try to move camp, and got it on a dry fly, so not a bad last fish to end it. So pretty, man. See ya, buddy. Time to pack up, get out of here, and we're gonna try to move camp before hopefully storms build. It's to the east, but you just don't know up here what's gonna happen, so let's get out of here. Well guys, it's been awesome up here, definitely worth the hike up. It's absolutely beautiful to catch cutthroat in here, but I don't think these storms are gonna hit us, but gonna be a little more prepared than yesterday. And I'm not upset about moving camp earlier anyways, because the quicker we have to hike up that canyon and get it done with, the better. Not looking forward to it, but it's not just the 900 feet and 2 miles that sucks. It's the footing is just awful, man. But that's all good. Got us here, so definitely worth it. So those waterfalls are the ones that are right by camp. And as you can tell, we got to go down. But I don't think it'll be too bad. I think right around the bend is where I scrambled up the first time. After this set of waterfalls, I'm gonna stay right. I think it's not too bad. I might try to climb. I climbed up some rocks there. It might be tough getting back down instead of going down. We'll see. But it's the magnitude of this valley is insane. It's beautiful. I wish I could catch these things on the 3-weight every day of my life. Just a chunky hen. Just destroyed the dry fly. Well, rain and storms are starting. I'm gonna do the smart thing and do about the hour hike to get where I wanna get camp set up. This right here has been one of my favorite wilderness lakes to fish. You saw the cookie cutter smallmouth, or why did I want to say smallmouth? Cutthroat. It's a ton of fun. Those things on the 3-weight hammer and dry flies were pretty fun. That's about it. Just the hike out. maybe moose and storms to come. That's about it.
Well, I wanted to do my stream crossing over there, but as you can see, Mr. Bull Moose is probably not happy about it. He's like right where I want to cross to. Oh. Gotta cross somewhere.